Wouldn't it be great if you could optimize your WordPress site for SEO without having to be an SEO expert? Well, there's a way. Hey everyone, I'm Neil Patel, and today I'm gonna break down WordPress SEO tutorial for beginners. Now, before we get started, make sure you subscribe to this channel, and if you're on YouTube, click the alert notification. Look, there are four areas that you need to focus on. Not only am I gonna go over each of them in detail, but I'll also tell you which plugins to use so you don't have to worry about the details and you don't have to learn any coding. Factor number one, site speed and performance optimization. Now, before I dive into the main points on this, here's why it's important. If your site loads slower, what you'll find is your conversion rate's drop. Just imagine, you're on your phone, you're doing a search on Google, you land on a site and you're like, man, the site's taking forever to load. If that's the case, what do? You're gonna sit there to wait for the site to load? Of course not. You're gonna click the back button and go to a different page. So you wanna make sure that your site loads fast. You know, Amazon themselves, if their website loads slow, there's an article that Fast Company did that broke down how they lose billions of dollars. Now that's Amazon. Of course, you're not gonna lose as much as them because none of us make as much of Jeff Bezos. But percentage-wise, we're gonna lose way more than them because we don't have as well of an established brand. Now there's a few things that affect your site load time. Cache, that's where people don't have to keep loading up your images and they know that you're saving the same ones over and over again, so they cache them. CDN stands for Content Delivery Network. That's taking your content and putting it all over the web. You know, servers in India and Brazil and United States. So that way, whenever someone's visiting your site from the UK, they don't have to, you know, crawl through the broadband, you know, pipes underneath the sea to visit your site. What they'll do is they'll just ping a server in the UK so that way it just loads faster. There's minification of images, not necessarily changing the size of the images, but it does change the file size. Then there's lazy load. You know, when you go to a site and you scroll down, there's no need for them to load up all the images at once. Instead, they should load them as you scroll so that way you can improve the experience. JavaScript, sometimes if you have too much JavaScript on your site, it can slow things down. And of course, image compression. Now, some plugins that are worth checking out that'll just do all this for you so you don't have to do it manually is WP Rocket, Nitro Pack, WP Fastest Cache, I love these names, W3 Total Cache, and WP Smush for image compression. Now, the second factor that you need to pay attention to is technical SEO. Look, if Google can't crawl your page and understand what's on your page or able to read the content on your site, how are you gonna rank for anything? And that's why technical SEO is super important. Everyone talks about link building, how you need all these links, you need content, and they're right. You do need links, you do need content. But if Google still can't crawl your website, understand the content on the page, and read the code, then it doesn't really matter how many links you have, you're not gonna really rank for much. So let's go over some of the technical SEO elements. There's a sitemap, that's a page or a file, and you can do one out of XML that just lists all your, you know, pages on your site or all your articles. Then you got your titles and meta descriptions. You know, whenever you do a Google search, you see a title and a text underneath that, a description, that's your title tag and meta description. Then you got your robots.txt file. This is a file that you can block Google from crawling certain pages. Let's say if you have a login page or a checkout page with credit card information, you don't want people just scraping that kind of stuff. You also need to check for broken links. You don't want Google to crawl a link and be like, this link doesn't go anywhere, it's dead. That makes you look bad. Then you got AMP pages. More people use Google from their mobile device than desktop devices. The AMP framework just makes it so that way your pages load faster on mobile devices, specifically for text-based articles. You also want to check your redirects. There's 301 redirects, 302 redirects. One's permanent, one's temporary, but that can cause the bots to go around in circles if they're doing, if you've done your redirects wrong. You also have schema markup. You know, whenever you go on Google and you're searching for a product or a restaurant, you're seeing those star ratings, that's an example of schema markup. Websites are passing that information to Google, so that helps. These days, we're also worried about security, so SSL certificates gives you that lock symbol next to your URL, And you know what? That just makes people feel more secure, and Google's looking for that when they're ranking websites as well. So some plugins that can help. There's an all-in-one SEO. There's a Yoast SEO plugin. There's SEO Press. There's Schema Pro for schema markup. There's Rank Math. There's really simple SSL. And there's AMP for WordPress. So check them out. You don't have to use all of them, but when I'm going through the list of plugins for each section, keep in mind, it's up to you to pick whatever ones you like, and there's no really wrong or right way. All plugins are getting better. Third point, content marketing. Look, if you write content, no matter how amazing it is, if no one reads it, no one sees it, you're not gonna do well. So you gotta really focus on the marketing of that content and making sure that your content is buttoned up as well. So a few factors, push notifications. You know, in your browser, whenever you're on, you know, searching on the web, especially if you're a Facebook user, it'll be like, oh, it's Neil's birthday. And they'll show you this little notification box that comes up. Clicking on that is a push notification, and you can actually send that out on your website so that way you can get more visitors. Then there's your grammar. No one wants to read content that's just poorly written, so make sure you check your grammar and fix it, because Google's like a thesaurus in a dictionary. They know what's good spelling, bad spelling, great grammar, bad grammar. If you're writing, I love using Grammarly. That helps me a lot because I have terrible grammar. Then you got your social sharing. You know, even though Facebook reach isn't that great compared to what it is years ago, still better than nothing, you know? You still want to share that content on Facebook and Twitter and LinkedIn and any other social site that's applicable to your website. And of course, you want to collect emails. They always say the money's in the list. So that way, whenever you create a new blog article, you can just, boom, send out an email blast and get that traffic rolling in. So here's some plugins to check out. Subscribers helps you with push notification. Hello Bar helps you with email collection and call to actions. And then you have Grammarly, which helps you with your grammar. And then Shared Counts, which helps you getting more social shares. The next factor, security. These days, we're all worried about privacy and security. You don't want hackers to inject malicious code into your website or publish fake content on your website, and it happens. So that's super important for you to avoid. So with security, you know, we did mention SSL earlier, but there's also a few other plugins that can help, like Security and WordPress. Those are two to check out. Now look, if you want to do it all manually, you can, but if you use these plugins, it'll give you a kickstart without having to learn all the nitty-gritty details of SEO. And if you just want my team to do it for you, check out my ad agency, NP Digital. And if you have any questions, leave a comment below. I'm here to help. If you enjoyed the video, like it, share it, tell people about it. Thank you for watching.